Everyone's being very polite and nice in a chat room. It's a first for the internet. I love that.
Yeah, that won't last.
Well, hello, everyone.
So, ladies and gentlemen, Luke Spencer does rock reviews on Channel Awesome and elsewhere. You can check him out on the YouTube, search for the rock reviews. How are you doing tonight, Luke?
Not bad. Everything's good right now. How are you doing? Are you still going to survive with your stomach issues?
I'm doing better than I was. I was not, you know, wanting to die this morning, which is super.
Wow. Your bar is very low for health quality.
Yeah, it is. Well, you know. You know, I wake up like, do I want to die today? No, okay, I guess I must be fine.
Oh, it's a Monday.
It's a Monday. let's see. So, we have the regular collection of nonsense and bullshit tonight. And this is your first time assisting with it. So I think you're familiar with the format.
I am. And I just wanted to point out, like I did before earlier today, not only do I not have a cat, I'm allergic to cats. I am the opposite of Tara. So I apologize in advance.
Okay, see, now they're going to hate you.
I just want to get it out of the way.
You just set that up.
I know, but I don't want to get everyone's, like, ideology of, like, a little kitten coming, like, pawing up my back and surprising everyone. It's just not going to happen. I'm sorry. I know that's what you guys wanted, but I'm sorry.
Well, you're just going to have to, like, go out and capture some other small, cute animal. Like, go on. We'll wait. Go on.
I do have a... Okay, I'll get my GoPro. This will be the first live on the street of what... WTF, yeah.
Yeah. Get the GoPro, walk around. Oh, hi, doggy! And then, you know, one emergency room trip later, and everything's wonderful.
Yeah, I know. So I could be reported on the story next week.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You're helping me out.
So this weird inception of everything that's going on, that's perfect.
Yeah, you're helping me out. I like that. All right, let's get the intro up here.
Oh, boy.
Each week, Catherine and the Radio Dead Air audience go out in the worldwide interwebs, find all sorts of horrible stuff, bring it back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck Is Wrong With You? And this week, I'm going to start with a story that just made me sad inside. Okay, I'll put it to you. Start with Blue. Do you know what cloud computing is?
Yes, I do.
Do you understand how cloud computing works?
Yes, I do.
Explain for the people at home.
In a very basic term, say you have a piece of data or a file that you want to save somewhere that you can access on other computers, other devices, things like that. If you have a cloud storage system, you can put that file on that cloud storage system and you can access it from many different servers, different locations, all the things like that, so long as you have access to it. However, things like the fappening can happen if you're not aware that you're posting things up to the cloud, and that's how your business gets displayed to the internet.
Yeah, but you know, one thing that does not have anything to do with cloud computing? Actual fucking clouds! 51% of Americans believe storms affect cloud computing. I don't... We have no excuse for...
Isn't that where they got the name?
A study has found that a large percent of Americans are a little foggy on what cloud computing actually is. Market survey done by Wakefield Research found for cloud computing firm Citrix asked 1,006 nationally representative adults aged 18 and older what they knew about the cloud. Results were, well, unsurprising when you consider how much confusing tech terms can be for the non-tech minded. A big chunk of residents, of respondents, 29%, thought that the cloud is something to do with meteorology, while only 16% first thought of computing. A whopping 51% believe that a storm could play havoc with cloud computing.
This was an 18 and older, an older survey. That is awesome.
You know, Arthur C. Clarke had this old quote about any sufficiently advanced technology could be mistaken for magic. We shouldn't have reached that point yet!
They are... So does that mean, like, they're confused also? Like, if a bird's flying through the cloud, is that, like, some type of terminology they're just not used to yet?
That's Twitter.
There you go. Yeah, you're right. Twitter.
It's like, you know, it's like in Game of Thrones where they get the ravens and they tie the little things to their legs and they send them through the cloud, and that's Twitter.
That's a tweet.
That is how when you are typing on your computer, someone somewhere is, come here, bird. We got to send this.
Do you think those tweets just go out on their own? No, we have to train some animals to do them.
Of course.
We have to.
51%.
I'm more stunned at the fact, like, this was an adult survey. This wasn't either little kids
no.
or the 65 and older who didn't grow up with computers. This is, like, the actual generation that was born with technology.
What this study means is there is a good, if not better, chance that surrounding you at any given point in time, one out of every two people is a moron.
Yeah.
One in two. You're like flipping a coin on that one.
I mean, explaining cloud, like the cloud, the idea of it to someone who doesn't even know the first thing about computers has got to be a mess enough. But you shouldn't have to reach, like, point outside and go, no. No, that's not it. No.
It does bring a whole new meaning to old man yells at clouds. Hey! Hey, where's my file?
Give me back my file.
Give me back
right now.
You son of a bitch. Well, we have entirely different sort of weather coming from Australia. And this isn't really anything humans did. This is pretty much what the fuck, Australia.
I like Australia too, but it is a wild and savage place.
So someone in the channel said earlier, the only thing that isn't trying to kill you, that won't kill you in Australia, is old age.
Yeah, if you get to old age in Australia, that is a miracle.
Hallelujah! It's raining spiders.
Ugh.
Raining spiders in Goulburn. Millions of baby spiders appear to be raining from the sky in the southern tablelands earlier this month, with one astonished local fearing the region had been, quote, invaded by spiders, and another reporting his home was covered in the creatures. Goulburn.
Oh my God.
You see the pictures. Look at that
I'm
shit.
Looking down, like, if you keep scrolling down, like, the third one, it looks like snow. Like, straight up snow
no,
on the ground.
No! That's spiders!
Oh.
Millions of baby spiders appear to be raining from the sky. The whole place was covered by these little black spiderlings, and when I looked up at the sun, it was like a tunnel of webs was coming from 100 meters in the sky.
Hey, that is a plague. That is a Bible plague.
Yes!
That's what the stuff Moses called down.
That's when you look outside and you're like, Roy, which one of you pissed off God again? Bruce?
Oh,
Bruce, have you been touching yourself? He knows.
Okay, where is it? I don't know, but you're going to need more than one can. Ugh.
This is, oh my God. And okay. The first thing I thought of, you ever play Warhammer 40K?
While ago, yeah.
The first thing I thought of was there's a concept in that game called the warp. And basically there's this Cthulhu-esque Lovecraftian dimension of evil Cenobite demons layered just below our reality. And every so often it busts open and horrific shit just pours onto these unsuspecting worlds. And I'm sitting there going, fucking call the Space Marines.
Yeah.
It's chaos.
Oh, I just scrolled down. There's a quote on here from one of the Australian ladies. It lasted for at least 30 minutes. It was quite amazing. What woman is this that is that calm about
this? She's from Australia. This is just a Tuesday.
It's just the month of May for her? That's it?
Right. Oh, it's spiders again. Okay. That happens.
I mean, like, what do you do? I mean, is there like a spider web cancellation for schools and stuff like that? The buses through that stuff. You can't expect people to go to work. I wouldn't go outside.
There's spiders everywhere. There's fucking spiders. It's like, yeah, it's like a game called on account of spiders.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh my God.
The PGA Tour was canceled because no golf balls could be found after the spider storm fell on every golfer and then every ball was lost.
Yeah, and I love it. Everybody in the store is just like, meh.
Yeah.
Australia, what are you gonna do?
How about that?
We kind of are
just again that third picture, like it's like a shed or a barn. Honestly, it's like piling up to the sides of the like the walls. Ugh.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful because of spiders.
Ugh. And I think the one thing I'm grateful about this, they did not zoom in. They did not show actually how many spiders.
That would creep
things.
Ugh.
Just how many there have to be, like, in every cubic foot of that nightmare.
Oh, Kaiser Nadler in the channel. Look, Mommy, I'm making spider angels. Well, let's...
Spider-Man within an hour. One of these has to be radioactive.
You would think, because they're coming...
The odds, I mean, yeah.
So, it's time to get back to some more regular crazy.
Okay.
And let's see, where is this?
I don't want to have nightmares tonight, so...
Okay, this comes to us from... Well, I don't know if this is nightmares so much as... Maybe. This is from L.A. And, all right. I have had a traffic stop before. Everyone has been stopped by the cops before. My normal response is, I get out my insurance, my license, I hand it over, and I wait to be fucked. Because in some way or another, this is not normally how I would respond to a traffic stop. Naked pursuit. Suspect in custody after rescue off Redondo Beach. A pursuit suspect had to be pulled from the ocean in Redondo Beach Thursday night after he fled his vehicle, ran into the water, removed all his clothing, and fought off rescuers. Incident began when the officer in the area of Catalina Avenue and Emerald Street observed a driver running a red light. That's not a big deal. That's not like...
He's acting like he had 10 pounds of coke and a dead body in the trunk.
No, officers turned on their light and sirens, but the driver did not pull over. The driver made a turn and continued driving in the direction of the beach after hitting and damaging a curb near the lifeguard tower. Driver got out of the vehicle and fled on foot to the water. The man was fully clothed when he got out of his car, but started stripping his clothing off when he got to the water. Went to the ocean. Police went into the ocean after the man. They caught up with him and attempted to get him out. He appeared to become combative and resist their rescue efforts.
Was this like the Tommy Boy scene? Was he trying to pull off the bees? Bees in the car! Taking it a step farther? Like he really thought that was going to work?
I don't know. Maybe he was like, international waters. International waters. I'm fine.
That's like 17 miles. If that guy can make it that far, he gets it. He's clean. I don't care. The cops should just like smile and applaud.
Shit. Oh.
And then, why the clothes, though? Is there an answer for that, or...?
No, they don't tell him why he started...
Is this in Florida?
No, this was L.A.
Oh.
Which is, well, you know, almost as bad.
Well, I actually am surprised. That does sound like a Florida special.
We've never seen anything like that, said co-captain Chris Luba. He had an unreal amount of energy. We grabbed each arm and tried pulling him out of the water, but he kept pushing off our boat.
The guy weighed 300 pounds? Police went into the ocean. Who rescued said, wait, 300 pounds. Oh.
And he just kept swimming out to sea. I clipped him into our rescue buoy, and he just kept fighting, kicking, and fighting. What was the plan? It's not like they'll never get me. They're going to get you.
Like, what's the exit? What's the escape after that? You're naked. You're 300 pounds. It's at night in L.A. You know, you're on the beach wet in the water.
Wait, when you come back in, it's going to be like the perfect crime. They'll never know it was me.
Just going to wait here till morning. That's all I got to do. 6 more hours.
I mean, Jesus Christ.
I mean... Was, like, if the guy was super drugged up, I can see him trying to run into the water. But, again, I don't get the clothing part. Why was he trying to, like, rip off his clothes and run to the water?
I guess he thought he would swim faster if he had less resistance. He was thinking, he's like, well, wait, no. If I'm going to pull this off, got to be naked. Otherwise, it's not going to work. Got to get the clothes off.
Oh my gosh, I'm wearing a Katy Perry shirt. I can't be seen with this in prison. I gotta take this off before I go. Two Harbor Patrol officers who fought to bring the man ashore. Yeah, you're... Ugh.
Hey,
that just blows my mind. I mean, I've heard stories about this before. People, like, take their shirt off out of, like, a defense mechanism for whatever reason. But... For what? What was the purpose of this? I mean, this was not that big of a deal.
They're less happy when they have to take you in naked.
Yeah.
They're already not happy that
you ran. The lifeguard has a reason not to save you. You don't want to give him reasons.
Oh.
That poor lifeguard, too. That's awful.
Well, we've got more overreaction to standard situations. And again, a comment I've had to say, it's become a theme on this show. A gun is not a remote control for life. That's not how that works. It's from Lebanon in Pennsylvania. Lebanon man charged with firing, quote, warning shot after car struck him. Now you're thinking it was like a hit and run. No, listen to this. Police have filed charges against a city man who said he fired a warning shot into the air after a passing vehicle struck his arm. Justin Burrell told officers he was walking when he was struck by a mirror of a gold PT Cruiser. He said he was concerned for his safety, so he fired the warning shot into the air as the vehicle was driving away. Burrell was not injured.
Well, I mean, I guess I'm sure he had a perfectly good reason to have a loaded gun with him walking the streets of Lebanon, Pennsylvania, in the safety off and pulling that, but...
No, I think the thing was, he was looking for a reason. That's one of those guys who's like, is it time? Yes. It's time! It's time! I can finally use this thing! Everyone see I have a gun!
That is reaching. I mean, come on, like, was he leaning into traffic? Like, the batter trying to get hit by the pitch type situation? Like, looking for a reason?
Come on!
One hoodie has got to do it, I dare you! I dare you! Oh! What's going on in Pennsylvania where the driving's that bad?
It just got clipped by a...
Yeah, it just grazed, yeah. And if he said it wasn't even hurt.
So then I pulled out my gun!
Yeah, that's what I was thinking. I mean, like, what do you do if you're the driver, too? I mean, really, if you're...
You drive faster!
I know, but still, like, if you are the one that clipped him and you knew it, you'd already be freaked
out.
It's
like, oh no, I hit the... Oh, fuck me! This is one of those thank God no one was hurt kind of things, because I don't understand how people can get a gun and not know basic shit like this.
Yeah.
What goes up must come down. And just because you fired the bullet up in the air.
Yeah.
Does not mean it's not going to hit
it
somebody.
It doesn't disintegrate.
No.
And also, I highly doubt in that time frame, he carefully turned around, looked for a safe spot in a mountain range and pointed it that way. Heck no. There's no way. He turned around and just shot it.
You will have the chance of hitting someone. This shit's not a toy. It's not, I mean, say you fired the gun and he stopped. Now what?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
You've already escalated to the fact that I have a firearm and I'm crazy enough to use it for no good reason.
Yeah, exactly. You've already gone past, I have a firearm and I used it. Now what's step three? Profit?
Yeah, there's no coming back from that.
Ugh.
Got some more motor vehicle mishappery. I guess mishappery, is that a word? It should be a word.
It is here. We have a lot of unfortunate words here in Florida that really should not be in the English language.
Yeah, you live there. I'm so sorry.
It's, you know, I've gotten used to it. So it does really put a smile on my face. I did see the worst thing at a concert here in Florida I've ever seen in any concert.
Oh, God.
A pregnant woman tried to get in the mosh pit. And you ask, how did I know she's pregnant? Well, she was only wearing a bikini top, and her belly button was protruding, as you would in a third trimester. Didn't even phase her. And what's interesting about that, like, this was not just some little concert either. This was Welcome to Rockville, one of the biggest festivals in the nation for rock music. There was over 50,000 people. So this one stage had thousands. So I was just walking back and I saw this woman like start to walk in, like jump into it. Literally, I saw about five guys go, yeah, whoa. Everyone was on the same page. Everyone stops. I mean, it was like literally the record stops and nobody even like tried to move after that. And she just walked away like it was nothing.
It's like, the first thing I'm thinking of is Highlander, Conor McLeod in his first fight. No one will fight me. They all run away.
Yeah. It was so bad. I mean, honestly, I was like walking. It stopped me dead in my tracks. And I could still feel my heart going just because, like, oh my gosh, there's no way that could have ended well for anyone.
Welcome to Florida.
So yeah, Florida at a concert too. People say people get crazy in concerts. Well, Florida concerts, you can imagine high class and well-respected individuals that can only attend one of the shows here.
Well, our next one's from a little bit further north than that. This is from Coventry, Vermont, but I'm kind of surprised this wasn't a Florida story.
Okay.
And this is not the first time this shit has happened. We have motifs. We have fucking motifs on this goddamn show. It drives me crazy.
I'm surprised you haven't had a somewhere, like, try to hide a gun up their butt yet.
Not yet.
Well, okay.
No, this is, speaking of driving crazy, mom, 5-year-old, rode on roof of speeding car. Mother and a boyfriend are charged after police say they took a 5-year-old for a joyride on the roof of a car.
So they let the 5-year-old teen wolf the car.
Yes.
Oh my God.
Investigators say a concerned citizen had pictures to prove it, showing Lindsay Perkins, 27, and her child sitting on the roof of a Subaru station wagon with Nicholas Nabaris, 20, at the wheel. Police say the car reached speeds of 50 to 55 miles per hour.
Oh my God. Ugh.
I'm reminded of George Carlin. Get on the plane, get on the plane. Fuck you, I'm getting in the plane.
Yeah.
There seems to be a lot less wind in here.
How bad did little Timmy react at that dinner party to where that was the punishment, where they tie you to the roof of the car?
You know what happens this time? No!
All right, you want to be that way? You're not riding in the car with us home. Hop up top, come on. Let's go.
It's just 50 miles an hour. That's not fucking around speed.
No, it's not. Like, I wouldn't even feel comfortable doing that at idle speed in an empty parking lot because nothing good's going to come out of that.
I'm a grown-ass adult. Now you're going to get up on the fucking roof of a car.
And this wasn't like some kids, too. 27?
Well, yeah, and the boyfriend was 20.
20. Oh, well, you know, that's still... Ugh.
Why would you? The 5-year-old probably thought this was the best day ever.
Or the worst day ever. They're still crying about it. I guess it depends on the 5-year-old. I'm just looking at the couple, like the picture right next to the article.
Yeah.
They look like they could have been normal.
They do. They look so nice and
they
sweet.
They look like they had a chance.
No.
And then they found meth.
No.
Ugh.
That would explain it, but no.
Yeah, it would. Yeah.
Speaking of drugs, hey.
Did not mean for that unfortunate segment.
We're in Canada this time. We have got this slate of drugs these days. I don't know. It doesn't specify what these guys were on. God only fucking knows. But I keep saying it, the old drugs, they still work.
But it's Canada. Know? What? How? They're the friendliest people in the world.
Well, this kind of holds with this. From Barrie, Ontario, two lost and stoned men called 911 to get out of a bush. Barrie police and EMS, with the help of dogs, found two 19-year-old men high on an illegal drug and had to call 911 when they couldn't find their way out of a bush.
Singular.
A bush.
One. So two men were in the same bush, too.
The 911 call came in Tuesday from the pair who said they were lost. Police said it became clear both men were under the influence of a drug of some sort. No shit.
Yeah.
Police said police and EMS, with the help of dogs, found the two 19-year-old men who were silently staring off into the sky. It took several attempts to talk to the men to determine they had consumed illicit drug and were extremely disoriented. If you are taking something that makes you get lost in the foliage, not multiple, singular foliage, uno.
And you needed Lassie to help bark you out of the bush too? You needed that much help?
What is it, Lassie? Two idiots in the fucking bush again? Okay, we'll be right there. Fuck.
Well, I don't understand. I'm having trouble understanding the concept. Like, how big was this bush? how do they get in it? How can they not see out of it? I mean, what? How bad of this situation could this have been? Not to mention, there was still cognitive enough to dial 911 and explain.
We are lost. Where are you? We are lost.
The world is green. Oh, it's all green. Oh, Canada. I like Canada.
But at least they were polite about it. They're like,
oh, yeah,
okay.
Yeah. And also, no charges will be laid.
So no charges. Cops, like, yeah. Jesus Christ.
The cops probably loved it, to be honest. The dogs liked it. They had a good time in the park, apparently.
I just see them walking around in a circle.
What do you tell your wife when you have to, like, when you have to get picked up at the state, like, at the state county prison cell, and that's what you got picked up for?
Hi, honey. I got lost in the foliage again.
Why were you outside naked walking around?
I don't know. This does not seem like a fun drug.
No.
This really does seem like a fun drug to me.
And I highly doubt they took the drugs while in the bush.
No.
So they did it somewhere else and found and ended up in the bush. So who knows where else that took them.
You know the first thing I thought of? Cows are some of the stupidest fucking animals. They're smart in some ways, but here's what happens during a cattle drive. Cows have this homing instinct where they'll go back to the last place they saw the cow. So they'll keep getting lost in pairs. Two cows will see each other, wander away, and then keep wandering back together to the last place they saw a cow. The rest of the herd is all the fuck away. They're like, you're here. Where's everybody else?
I don't know.
And I'm thinking...
The buddy system doesn't work with cows.
I'm thinking, you go that way, I'll go this way, we'll go get help. And they just keep going in the circle, and man, you ain't found nobody yet. No. No.
This doesn't look like the bar, but you're here, so we must still be at the bar. Ugh. It's just, I mean, the cow analogy works perfectly, but still, this is the type of thing I'm kind of glad they didn't point out what drug they were on, because people would try it right after.
Of course, they
would, without even thinking, they would go, oh, heck yeah.
Dude, people heard about that bath salt. Oh, you'll eat somebody's face. I gotta try that shit.
Oh, yeah. I was in Florida for that mess. I mean, that reached all the way up to like 5 hours away where I am from that area. Ugh.
Now they have a new one called Flaca. Where do they name it? It's apparently it's another meth derivative like bath salts that makes you fucking crazy.
So it's another homemade bathtub drug.
Yeah.
That was made by Bob and Don. Two guys just met each other one weekend and said, you know what? We got Drano, we got Windex. We're going to snort it.
Yep.
Let's get together and do, like, find a way.
But that's not to forget that even the old drugs, can cause some problems. Our last story tonight actually comes, we have a Florida this week. I'm amazed. This one comes from Massachusetts. We are often told, don't drink and drive. I think this is the first time authorities have ever had to say, don't get drunk and chase the bears. Police in Massachusetts have some sage advice. Don't go chasing after bears while drunk and armed with nothing more than a dull hatchet.
They had to specify while drunk.
North Adams police wrote on their Facebook page that someone did just that on Monday. The department noted the drunken man was taken into protective custody. No name was released. Police say anyone who sees a bear should leave it alone and call authorities. These are words you should not have to say. There are some things in life you just know.
Why did he have a hatchet? Why was he drunk in the woods? Why are people doing this stuff outside in nature? What is going on in the world right now, in our continent, where the great outdoors is the new party scene?
They're fucking with the bears. They don't get, bears do not give a shit about you. You are just louder food than normal.
You have a hatchet and that's it.
A dull, hatchet.
I highly doubt you know how to use it.
Well, Davy Crockett killed him a bar and he was only three.
That's the line too. That's the line. It says right by the bear. They said they don't want to see anyone going all Davy Crockett.
I am older than three. I can do this.
Listen here, Baloo. I saw you scratch your butt on the tree in that song, or movie, or book.
This definitely smells of hold my beer.
Watch the hey y'all watch this. Yeah.
This
hold my beer and give me that hatchet. That's the last sentence most people would say in their lifetime if that goes in that order.
I cannot believe how anyone drunk or sober would look at this and go, yeah, I can take that. They are, if you have ever even seen.
Yeah, they're not like on TV where they're like the perspective's gone. They are literally 1,000 pounds of death.
They are like big puppy dogs. You can just see the girth of them moving. It's like an ATV vehicle. It's like one of those fucking yes, G.I. Joe vehicles they used to unload all the troops out of.
It's a full-size Harley, like a full-size motorcycle, but taller, and can stand up on its hind legs and swat at you.
And it doesn't like you.
No.
You're making it angry.
You're coming to their home. Just remember that, too. You're the one coming after it. How drunk are you to the point where... And why did... I get upset about stories like this. Like, there's all these missing pieces to the puzzle.
Yeah.
Why did they have a hatchet and we're drunk outdoors?
It's like we're coming in on page 3 and you need a flashback to how we got there 2 weeks earlier, you know.
We're going to Quentin Tarantino our own lives and just make up the story later when we go along. Oh, that poor bear, too. The bear just has this look like, I hate this park.
I love how that's the first place everybody, oh, that poor bear.
Yes.
Because no way, because you don't want that guy coming after you drunk. The bear don't want it either.
No, not at all.
This is the kind of fucker at the party you're like, Dave, you've had enough. Put the shit down. Put it down.
That's the guy you don't want at the party at all when they see him walk in the door. Just leave. We didn't invite you.
Hey, I thought this is America.
Hey,
what?
Hey. The party doesn't start till the hatchet says so.
Ugh. I don't, you know, I am very for, like, animal rights and stuff, but I also understand you have to protect yourself. If you're in a nature situation and, like, animals are coming at you, yeah, you definitely have the right to protect yourself in case of injury or death, but why are you poking the bear? There's no other way to say it. Why are you poking the bear with a machete or a hatchet?
This is definitely one of those, you know... I have been so drunk in my life. I have never been this drunk. And I almost stole an Olympic torch once. Or attempted to. I have been that drunk. Awesome. No, it's not. It's really
That's
not.
Drunk.
That's drunk. I thought that was a good idea. I thought I could... You know, but no.
When was that?
Oh, years and years ago.
Years, okay. I remember my favorite story, like, was in Utah. My sister was in Utah during the 2002 Olympics. One of the guys working there had to go bring in an axe to, like, chop some pieces off for whatever reason for, like, the opening ceremony. I don't remember what it was for. The security asked him, what's the axe for? For chopping people up. He was gone like that.
No, you don't say that. They don't...
Like that.
They
like,
don't have a... carried out. They don't have a sense of humor at the Olympics. I guess the first thing we learned this week is don't drunk in bear.
Don't drunk in nature. Why are you drunkening nature anyway, if that's even a term? But look at that picture, that poor bear.
Yeah, I just wanted to sleep. I just wanted to fucking...
I woke up my hibernation early for this.
Yeah, I know. The bear doesn't like that. We've learned that... Any drug that can get you lost in a single piece of foliage probably isn't a good drug.
I hope they save that 911 call. I really hope they save that call. It has to be online somewhere.
911, what is your emergency? Green! It's green!
Ugh.
We've learned that the roof is not for surfing.
No.
Anything they did in Teen Wolf is not something you should do in real life.
Exactly. Yeah.
Anything.
At what point did they think, you know what? You're a man now. You just graduated kindergarten.
You deserve a shot on top. Come on.
We've learned that if you start with firearms, you have no place to go. That's not the beginning of the confrontation.
Step one, fire gun. Step two, step three, profit. Yeah, it makes as much sense as what it was going to go in that story. So
we've learned that maybe you can escape in international waters, but the likelihood of such a thing occurring is quite low.
Yes.
Especially if you're naked. We learned that in Australia, everything is death.
Don't live in Australia. People there are very nice. I've met many of them. Why are you living off there? Get off that island. Let it go.
It obviously doesn't want you there. This is like the house in the horror movie going, get out. Only it's a whole continent.
There's no place safe on one square inch of that entire continent island. What are you doing there? I don't care how pretty the beaches are. You're going to die.
And finally, we learn when you're out in public, one out of every two persons is not a smart person.
Yeah.
And
some people can't computer, you know? They just can't.
And if you see your neighbor yelling at her at a cloud, she's not crazy.
She had her nudes leaked.
Yes, she's just having problems with Instagram.
Yeah.
That's it.